It's really hard for us to understand just how immense the universe is, and just how many galaxies and stars are out there. We're not sure about the exact number, because everything in the known universe slips into the darkness past the event horizon, that region of space-time beyond which events cannot affect us. For all we know, there could be an infinite number of galaxies and stars, and for the record, not all stars explode. Some just die out. But what if something strange and mysterious happened that suddenly caused all the stars in the universe to simultaneously explode? There are many different types of stars that exist in the universe. Yellow dwarf, orange dwarf, red giants, blue giants, magnetars, and neutron stars, just to mention a few. To understand what kind of fireworks we would see in the night sky, let's figure out as best as we can how many stars we would see explode and what effect it would have on our planet. If we were to look at the observable universe and count the stars, we would start with galaxies. From what we can see, there are 10 billion galaxies out there. Of course, not all galaxies are the same size, and our own Milky Way galaxy has about 100 to 300 billion stars. So if we do the math on 10 billion galaxies with a low average of 100 billion stars, that comes out to be about 1 billion trillion stars. Now just imagine for a minute that all these 1 billion trillion stars exploded at the same time. That would be really intense. But a star has to have mass to explode, or it won't. In fact, any neutron star whose mass exceeds 3.2 solar masses will collapse and create a black hole, and some stars simply collapse into a black hole without any pyrotechnics. More on that later. But now we will still entertain this idea that they will all explode at the same time. When a star explodes, it creates one of the most powerful and beautiful explosions in space. Supernova are relatively common. It was once thought that these were the brightest explosions in space. But recently, some astronomers have discovered mysterious explosions of stars 10 to 100 times brighter than a supernova. So how does a star go supernova? The more massive a star, the faster it burns up its supply of fuel. Hence, the shorter its life. Our own star is 4.5 billion years old, at half its life expectancy, and it's been around that long because of its smaller size. It sounds a bit confusing, and you would think that the larger the star, the longer it would take to use up its fuel. However, the most massive stars can go supernova just after a few million years of fusion. This is based on the massive forces of gravity due to their sheer size, which makes them consume their fuel much faster than smaller stars. Those massive stars quickly exhaust their fuel supply and explode when the core of the star collapses in on itself. Sometimes, a black hole is often accompanied by a supernova explosion, but only if it has enough mass. The core of the star may collapse to form a black hole, while the outer envelope may build up enough energy and heat during the collapse so that it goes supernova and escapes. Supernova create shock waves, called galactic winds, that blast out large amounts of gas and dust. These shock waves expand outward and can move as fast as 8 miles per second. These explosions emit a lot of kinetic energy into interstellar space and travel forever until they die out, which can take hundreds of years. But even a supernova isn't the most powerful explosion, as we are discovering more each day. A hypernova, or what is called a collapsar, is a very energetic supernova thought to result from an extreme core collapse scenario. In this case, a massive star, equal to 30 solar masses, collapses to form a rotating black hole, emitting twin energetic jets, and surrounded by an accretion disk. Let's say that this happened, and we were all standing on Earth and staring out into space. We might see a lot of bright flashes from stars in our own galaxy, and with so many stars exploding at once, that night sky would probably light up brighter than day. However, because the universe is constantly expanding at incredible speeds, the explosions far away from us would appear in slow motion, even though the shock waves would be traveling very fast. We would likely be watching that explosion for 10 years or more, and it would take many years before we saw all the light from these explosions in space. There are also places in the universe that are heavy with gas clouds and interstellar dust. Some of these are called star nurseries, where stars are formed. If there were an explosion in one of these areas of space, it could cause a chain reaction, where stars exploded and more stars were created from those explosions. It would be like a never-ending chain reaction. And those places where stars are born would become the brightest spots in the universe. But what about us and our own sun? We said all the stars, and ours would be no exception. That said, we probably won't be around long enough to see any of this happen. We have already dealt with powerful effects from the sun, such as solar flares and solar winds, which are produced by magnetic explosions. These magnetic explosions that produce solar flares are as powerful as a billion atomic bombs and magnetar flares that release more energy than even the largest supernova explosions. In the Earth atmosphere, they fuel magnetic storms and auroras, and in fusion reactors, they are dreaded as the source of a catastrophic failure. Now, our own sun isn't going to explode, even after it uses up all its fuel. That is because it simply does not have the mass. Physicists say that our sun still has another 5 billion years left before it burns up all of its fuel. And instead of going supernova, it is now believed that it will turn into a massive ring of luminous interstellar gas, also called a planet nebula, long after its transition into a red giant. However, if the sun were suddenly to explode in a spherically symmetrical way, then according to both general relativity and Newton's theory of instantaneous force, the sun's gravitational pull on the Earth would not change appreciably until matter from the sun passed the Earth's orbit, which would be about 22 hours after the sun exploded. That's assuming it's a typical supernova explosion. This changed configuration of matter would be felt instantly at all distances from the sun. Of course, if all the stars were to explode, meaning even our own sun, the effects on the Earth would likely be catastrophic for a few reasons. The massive amount of heat and radiation from the explosion would probably boil the seas dry, and a massive electromagnetic pulse would wipe out all power and communications. The shockwave would be tremendous, and we would immediately feel the effect. The human race would never recover from such a catastrophe. So in short, we wouldn't be around long enough to see the rest of the light show in the observable universe, but it surely would be an incredible sight. Debris and dust clouds, or these galactic winds, would likely strip the Earth of its atmosphere. It might not be instantaneous, but there would be other problems that the Earth and other planets would face if our sun exploded. Newton's theory of gravity claims that if the sun were to suddenly explode, the Earth, some 93 million miles away from the sun, would instantaneously suffer a departure from its usual elliptical orbit. Even though it might take light from the explosion 8 minutes to travel from sun to the Earth. In Newton's theory, knowledge that the sun had exploded would be instantaneously transmitted to the Earth through the sudden change in the gravitational force governing its motion. The Earth and all the other planets would fly out into space off course at 67,000 miles per hour. In fact, the entire Milky Way galaxy, which is traveling through space at an average speed of 515,000 miles per hour, would change drastically and may not even resemble a galaxy anymore once all the stars in it exploded. It would likely be the end of everything as our planet floated through cold space, or what was left of it and our civilization. Some humans could possibly survive underground if the effects of the initial blast didn't wipe out the entire planet at once. But there is no reason to worry or become anxious over the idea of all the stars exploding in the universe, or any kind of catastrophe that would be caused by our sun. Of course, there is always the chance of powerful solar flares, which can cause a lot of damage to our fragile planet. But our sun has been quiet lately, and in fact, going into a solar minimum, which could last 10 years or more. There is no telling what will happen to the universe, and anything is possible when we look at the biggest mystery of all. And that is, our universe is permeated with a vast, unseen force that seems to oppose gravity. The force is known as dark energy, and is what is pushing our universe outward. It may be possible that one day, in the blink of an eye, that the entire universe could collapse backwards on itself into a tiny speck. We live in exciting times, and as technology becomes more advanced, the more we discover. We hope you enjoyed this video. Let us know what you thought in the comments. Have an idea for a topic? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching.